children, welcome to the second term online class. Class 6, subject science. In unit 4, air, let me see the burning and combustion topic. When we burn a candle, paper, kerosene, cooking gas, wood or etc., oxygen is needed. The oxygen needed for the burning of candles, paper, kerosene, wood or cooking gas or comes from the air around us. If the burning substance will not get oxygen, the substance will stop burning. In rockets, as they go high in the atmosphere, the availability of oxygen considerably reduced. Therefore, in rockets, along with fuel, oxygen is also carried for combustion. In this, we saw two things, that is burning and combustion. So, what is the definition for burning and combustion? Let me see. Burning. The process of burning of a substance in the presence of oxygen and releasing a large amount of light and heat is called burning. And what is combustion? If the process does not emit flame, then it is called combustion. This is the difference between burning and combustion. Let we have a small experiment that shows oxygen is necessary for burning. Place two candles on a table. Ensure that both the candles are of same size and height. Mark them as candle 1 and candle 2 using a chalk piece. Light both the candles. Now, cover candle 2 with a glass tumbler as shown in the figure. Observe the happenings at both the candles. In candle 1, it continues to burn unless it is blown off by strong moving air or any other external force. This is because fresh air is continuously available to the candle for its burning process. Candle 2 glows for a while and then gets put off. When the burning candle is covered with a glass tumbler, the candle can use the oxygen available in the air inside the glass tumbler. Since only a small amount of air is present inside the glass tumbler, only a small portion of oxygen is available for the candle to continue glowing. When all oxygen of the air inside the gas jar is used up, then the burning candle gets extinguished. So this shows that oxygen is needed for the burning. Importance of air in plants. Air is important for the plants for respiration and for photosynthesis. Respiration in plants. Plants require energy for their growth and hence respiration also occurs in plants. During respiration, plants take in oxygen and release carbon dioxide, just as animals do. This gaseous exchange with air in atmosphere takes place in plants with the help of tiny holes called stomata present on their leaves. Next, photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? Plants manufacture food by the process called photosynthesis. During photosynthesis, carbon dioxide from the air and water from the soil react in the presence of sunlight to produce food. Most plants possesses a green pigment called chlorophyll, and it is also used up in the process of photosynthesis. Plants release oxygen during photosynthesis, which is much more than the oxygen consumed by the plants during respiration. We can express this photosynthesis with the help of a small equation. Carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of light energy that is absorbed by the chlorophyll will give us glucose, that is starch prepared by the food, and also it releases the oxygen. Carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of light energy gives glucose and oxygen. This equation shows you the process of photosynthesis clearly. Next, we are going to see about the respiration in animals. When we breathe in air, the oxygen present in the air reacts chemically with the digested food within the body to produce carbon dioxide gas, water vapor, and energy. The process by which oxygen reacts with the digested food to form carbon dioxide, water vapor, and energy is called respiration. Let's see the equation of respiration. Glucose plus oxygen gives up carbon dioxide plus water plus energy needed for our body. This process is called respiration in animals. Let's see the carbon dioxide formed during respiration dissolves in the blood and it is exhaled out of the body through the lungs. Let us have a look at the following table to compare the composition of air in inhaled and exhaled air. The component nitrogen, inhaled air 78% nitrogen is there, and in exhaled air the same amount, 78% exhaled out. Oxygen 21% in inhaled air, 16% in exhaled air. Carbon dioxide 0.03% in inhaled air and 4% in exhaled air. Water vapor in variable amount, it may be in inhaled air, and the amount increases in exhaled air. In noble gases, 0.95% in inhaled air and same amount will be in exhaled air. Dust particles, variable amount in inhaled air and none in exhaled air. Temperature, room temperature in inhaled air and body temperature is in exhaled air. So how the respiration happens in plants and animals in water? The plants and animals that live in water uses the oxygen dissolved in water for their breathing. Animals like fish uses their gills for their respiration, and frogs respire through their skin. Uses of air. Air is used for breathing for animals and plants, and also it is used for burning fuels like wood, coal, kerosene, LPG, etc. And compressed air is used to fill tires of various kinds of vehicles. And in ozone layer, air present in the ozone layer, present in the atmosphere, helps in preventing harmful radiations of the sun from reaching the earth's surface. When it is get depleted, the ultraviolet rays from the sun directly enter into the earth. So, ozone layer prevents us from the ultraviolet rays of the sun. Do you know carbon dioxide, which is present in air, cooled to minus 57 degrees Celsius, it is known as dry ice. It is a good refrigerating agent for exporting perishable food items. This is also a uses of air. And now, today's homework part. Uses of air in windmills. In windmill air, how do you use it in various processes? Number 2, uses of air in deep sea diving and mountain climbing. I hope you understand this session very well. Let you meet in the next session. Thank you.